tool to battle the epidemic that the CDC says killed more than 33,000 Americans last year. Now $1 billion will be made available to address the nation's opioid crisis over the next 2 years. And that's not the only medical issue getting some major funding. Moments ago, with Vice President Joe Biden by his side, President Obama signed the 21st Century Cures Act, which makes $6.3 billion available to tackle some of the biggest health challenges of our time, including the so-called moonshot that could be a giant leap in the fight to cure cancer. Let's bring in CNN chief medical correspondent Dr. Sanjay Gupta. And Sanjay, this legislation covers a lot of ground and is a big deal for the medical community.
No doubt. I mean, this has been something that people have been talking about for quite some time. Frankly, weren't sure if it was going to actually happen, Jake. But you mentioned one of the big ones, the cancer moonshot, accelerating therapies, making therapies more widely available, detecting cancers earlier, making those diagnoses. That is a lot of what the moonshot's about. They used the word cure once in the report. I read the entire report. Cure is only used once, but the notion of making these cancers more of a chronic disease is really a lot of what the cancer moonshot's about. But there's also money in there for the brain initiative, Jake. There's money in there for what is known as precision medicine, to try and individualize medicine. The middle one, $500 million for FDA drug approval. Common complaint, takes too long to get drugs approved. They want to make that go faster. And then, as you mentioned in the beginning, you know, opioids, we cover a lot of that. Drug overdoses, number one cause of unintentional death in America today. They want to start addressing that problem. So $1 billion set aside for that.
But you say that the word cure is only in there once. Does that mean that this is being sold as a way to cure cancer, but that's maybe not the most realistic outcome of this all?
Well, you know, it's people, especially the scientists, are going to be reluctant to use the word cure. It's sort of the touchdown, the home run, certainly, that everybody wants. But it's not to diminish, I think, what is incremental progress along the way. And I think one of the ways to think about it, if you think about someone like Jimmy Carter, Jake, who has metastatic melanoma to his brain, and yet by all accounts is doing well on a new sort of therapy, is his cancer cured? No. Is it gone? No. You'd still see it if you got imaging. But he is not being affected by it. It's more of a disease that he's basically able to successfully battle. So they're just careful with that. I think cure is still, I think, what the aspiration is, but it's not to diminish all the steps in between.
Are there any of these diseases that are close to a cure that this funding could really help?
Well, I think, you know, one of the big areas is around the brain initiative, and specifically with Alzheimer's disease. You got, you know, about 5 million people in the United States who have Alzheimer's. Those numbers expected to quadruple over the next 25 years or so. Close is a relative term, Jake, but I think you're having a lot more insight into what exactly is causing Alzheimer's, and some surprising new therapies may come about as a result.
All right, Dr. Sanjay Gupta, thank you so much.